Hey guys, what's happening? Do you know how hard it is to work when you get an email like I got today? It's real hard. Let me talk about this email. I'm just plugging along, doing my Zooms, my conference calls, whatever it is, just working, doing my thing, minding my own business. Happened to check my email and boom, email from Skyloom about Luminar AI and about a new feature that they're bundling into that where, you know how we used to replace skies in Luminar 4, which by the way, we've only had that for about a year. It seems like I've had it forever because I've been doing these sky replacements for so long, but it's only been a year. But Luminar AI is coming and they've rebranded sky replacement as Sky AI. And at launch, when we first get Luminar AI, it's gonna have Sky AI version 1.0, right? Which is basically sky replacement that you know from Luminar 4. But the email today is all about what's coming in Sky AI version 2. Which, by the way, version 2 of that will be an update to Luminar that's going to come in 2021. I don't have the timing. I don't know. But it's basically, here's what we used to do. We'd replace the sky, and if you needed to reflect that, you'd add a new layer, get that sky file, flip it, transform it, move it around, mask it in, all that kind of stuff. Sky AI 2.0 is going to do that for you. It's sky replacement with automatic reflections with just a couple of sliders. It's super cool. I've been super distracted reading about this, talking to some of their people and watching their video and taking screenshots. They also sent me some graphical assets. Let's just look at them. Here we go. On the left is what we're going to have at launch. Again, launch for Luminar AI is targeted for, let's call it December sometime. They're saying holiday season. I don't have a firm date. Do not hold me or them to any specific date. I'm just gonna say for the sake of argument, mid-December, all right? I'm making it up, but let's just say mid-December. Sky AI 2.0 will come sometime in 2021. I have no idea when, but I cannot wait to get it. Trust me, this is gonna be exciting. So what we're gonna have at launch is on the left-hand side, which is sky replacement. Later, an update to Luminar AI will include version 2.0, which includes that reflection. You can see how the reflection just mirrors the sky down below and lines it up. It looks beautiful. Here we go. Here's an example screenshot they sent us, and you can see this is Vesterhorn in Iceland, and beautiful photo, but blue sky, kind of boring. Hey, it'd be really cool if you added some really interesting clouds and made it kind of dramatic. Same thing I've actually done with photos of mine from Vesterhorn, in fact, in a video a couple of weeks ago. But here it is with the reflected sky. That just looks so cool. Here's one of Elia Licardi's gorgeous images. It started out as just a blue hour image. You can see sky replacement that we know today on the left-hand side with that sky in it. Sky AI 2.0, again, coming in an update to Luminar AI sometime in 2021, will have reflected sky. I'm so excited about this. There it is, a little bit closer view of that screenshot. There's another one. And let me show you this because here's what I want you to look at, my friends. This is a screenshot I took from their video, which is on YouTube. Go check it out. If you haven't subscribed to the Skyloom channel, do that as well. But if you look over here, you're familiar with horizon blending and relight and all that. That stuff is going to continue to work. It looks as is, but water reflection and water ripples is now included. Again, this is in Sky AI 2.0 that's coming later as an update. At launch, when you get Luminar AI, it's not going to have this. That's going to be Sky AI 1.0. I'm saying that a lot, but I'm trying to be really clear about it. But it looks like all you're going to do is take a slider for water reflection and just scooch that over to the right, and then water ripples if you want that. Add those, and I can't tell if you can go left to smooth it out or not. I'm not sure, but you can kind of see what's going on there. Some really, really cool stuff that I think is just another amazing AI innovation from our friends over there. Here's another screenshot, and once again, you can see the water reflection and water ripples. This is just a different sky. This one, a little bit more of a sunset reflected in the water. And there's that one again. Here's a couple of screenshots from their video, Sky AI 2.0 with water reflections. There's that whole scene. And there it is as a, I should increase the size of these, make it a little bit better to see. Let me go back to this one here. I'm looking at that and I mean, it looks fantastic the way the sky has blended into the water. If you look at that, now I don't have the original photo, of course, it's not mine. This is a Elia Licardi's photo, but it looks like that reflection. I mean, if you look over here, like the castle reflected, it's kind of blue there, just like it is kind of blue up above in the real sky. But over here, there's, you know, layered clouds and different colors and same kind of looking thing there. The lightning one, this is kind of mind-boggling. I just think this is so cool. So on this left-hand side, right, blue sky, reflected blue sky, that's cool. But if you look at this, there's the lightning bolts, and look how it's coming in. It's detecting the bridge. It's even going through the bridge, like this little hand railing here, it looks like, which is what's so great about sky replacement, and coming out over here, which I'm still just amazed by. And then they've got sky reflections down here in the water. And golly, I need to increase the size of these. Sorry, my friends. Here's that Wanaka tree that everybody shoots in New Zealand. I've never been. Someday I'm going to go. I hope it's still there. But there it is with the reflected sky. And here's that same image. Sorry, I need to increase the size of these with a nighttime sky. And you can see how it's softened up based, it looks like, on water ripples and water reflection. It looks like it's kind of softened up that Milky Way and the stars in the sky. And then here's one more screenshot. I think that's all I have for you. Yeah, I'm excited about this. I hope you're excited about it. If you've already pre-ordered Luminar AI, look forward to getting it. As soon as I get it, which, by the way, I think is going to be kind of soonish, I should be able to get a preview copy to start playing around with. And trust me, as soon as I'm allowed to share screenshots and things like that that I have from my own copy, including videos, trust me, I will be doing that. So I'm looking forward to that. But I just had to make a video about this because this reminds me, the energy and excitement for me about this is the same high level as I had when they first announced sky replacement over a year ago. And I've loved that tool. I'm sure you have. If you have Luminar 4, it's amazing. Other people are starting to do the same thing. It's kind of funny how that's caught on. But it's always been, hey, how do you do the reflection? New layer, flip the layer, mask it in, blah, blah, blah. They're letting AI take over and do it for us. I'm excited to try this out. Again, it'll come as an update in 2021. We'll learn about that later. Just wanted to share a quick preview of that. If you've already seen their video, then this is kind of a repeat, but I had to share it because I love talking about it. And frankly, I've had so many questions from you folks about, hey, are they going to be able to do something cool like that? Looks like they are. As I learn more, I'll share it here. Thanks for watching, my friends. You guys take care. I'll be back really soon, as soon as I can, with more Luminar AI info and, of course, regular Luminar tutorials. Thanks for watching. Take care, my friends. I'll see you really soon, and adios.